Hello friends, this is Dr. Vishal Verma and we will be doing a topic called of ecology. This entire course will be comprising of all the parts of the ecology and we will try to cover as much as possible. So this is suitable for all the people who are interested in a subject called ecology. Now when we talk about the concept of ecology, there are different definitions. Okay, so let's understand the concept of what is actually ecology so that it will be creating a benchmark for us and a platform for us on which we will be understanding the different topics related to ecology. Now, ecosystem simply meaning as the ecological system. Ecology is defined as the study of the ecosystem. Ecologists study the interaction of all the organisms in the ecosystem. The study includes complex interaction between thousands of plants and animals and on to the roles of microbes living under the soil at the effect of the tropical rainforest of the Earth atmosphere. The study done by the ecologist can help us understand the world around us and how that can influence our lives in a positive way by improving the environment and managing our natural resources and protecting the public health. So according to Wikipedia, the term called ecology is defined as the scientific analysis of the study of interaction between organisms and their environment. It is an interdisciplinary field that includes biology and earth sciences. Ecology includes the study of interaction organisms have with each other, other organisms, and with the biotic components of their environment. So ecology, according to the Ecological Society of America, is the study of the relationship between the living organisms, including human, and their physical environment. It seeks to understand the vital connection between the plants and the animals and around them. Ecology also provides the information about the benefits of the ecosystem and how we can use the Earth's resources in a way that leaves environment healthy for the future generation. The best way to understand what is ecology is to understand the study of the relationship within a given environment. So for example, we can take our home as an ecology. So there are many resources that is available. So if we talk about food, the food resources are available. Say in case of our kitchen, then there are resources that is related to your using the bedroom, using the different rooms of your house. So entire this system, and then we also know that when there is a food there, that food get decays within a period of time, so that there is a odor that is generated. Now all these components in the rooms, and when we are talking about the individual people living in the organism in the house, so not only the humans are living in the house, if there can be pets, then there can be n numbers of different microbes, the insects, spiders, lizards, and everything. So all this interaction, so we regularly interact with each of this. For example, a lizard is inside our house is interacting with the insects. Okay, now insects on a regular basis, say if it is a mosquito, it is constantly interacting with the human being. Although it can be a negative or the positive interaction. So when we are talking about any kind of interaction, we are basically concentrated about the interaction among the different organisms. Now when we live in a house, we also have the air in the house, food in the house, okay, water in the house. Now this forms the abiotic component of the house. So if we take environment, so our home or our house is also a ecosystem. Okay, to make it very simple, we can use this example. So basically, let's go into a history of some ecology. The term ecology was coined by a German zoologist, Hans Eckel, in 1966 to describe the economies of the living forms. The although Haeckel has not used the word of ecology a lot, the maximum use of the word of ecology was done by Ritter, and that is why Ritter is also known as the father of ecology. But Ritter's work was more concentrated on the animal ecology rather than on the plant ecology. Warming, there was a scientist called Warming that is called as the father of ecology. Professor Ramdev Mishra is considered as the father of the Indian ecology. And Eugene P. Odom, who has written a number of books, he actually has pioneered in the uses of the ecosystem ecology. So he has considered ecology not as a single thing, but as considered as the ecosystem ecology. So he is known as the father of ecosystem ecology. So while there can be questions related to the thing, if it is father of ecology, it will be Ritter. If your question is being asked father of plant ecology, it will be Warming. If father of Indian ecology, Professor Ramdev Mishra. And father of ecosystem ecology or the modern ecology, we say Eugene P. Odom. Okay. Now let's understand the concept of ecology. This particular 5 minutes of session will actually explain and set the ground of all the things. So the lowest category is the organism. Okay. So organism, we human are an organism. Then we have got cow, we have got dogs. Okay. Or we have got different plants. Now this plants as an individual is an organism. Okay. Now this organism actually comes into the form of the species. We are not going on the concept of taxonomical species. We will be concentrating here only related to ecological species. Okay, so the definition will be basic of a species will be concentrated more on the concept of ecologies. Okay, so when we have got the organism, now some of the organisms who are related to each other, who are physically or you can say structurally related common organism, these common organisms when grouped together will be forming what we call as the species. Now when there are different species, okay, so when say for example, if say certain species is residing in an area A, okay, so if all the species residing in area A, then this group of single species forms the population. Now we can understand here also when we will be describing the going deep into the concepts of ecology, different concepts of ecology, we will see that species, understanding of the species itself is very important. Then we'll followed by the population ecology. And this population, when because see, for we human do not only reside in a particular area. So apart from the humans, we have got different pets, then we have got different microbes, we have got different insects, we have got different reptiles, we have got different plants. Okay, so all this different populations. So if we take humans as one of the organisms, so this group of organisms basically forms the species. These species are in a particular area, say for example in an area A, it will becoming the population. Now in this is not mandatorily that all the persons, so there will be the population related to your pets, the cow, then it can be related to your dogs, cats, etc. Now all those different population of the different species, now they will be for part of the entire group. That is what we will be call as the community. Okay, so that's the higher level. So we go at the species level of ecology, then population ecology, then on the basis of that, when we move forward, we become the community ecology. Now till the part of the community ecology, these are all the biotic components. Okay, so this actually be it organism, which is the lowest category. Okay, moving from organism to the species to the population to the community. Okay, and then this all forms the biotic component. When there is an interrelationship, because we know that if there is no water, if there is no air, if there is no say we do not have water, air, soil or anything, so we will not able to survive, not even plants, not even humans, not even any organism. Okay, so there is very important part that is played by the abiotic component. Now abiotic components includes your you know, sunlight, includes your temperature, includes your related to your water, related to soil. Okay, so all these are basically the abiotic component. Now these components along with the biotic components, that can be at the level of a species or at the level of the population or at the level of this community, forms the ecosystem. Okay. Now all this ecosystem, so there can be, say for example, we can say we have got a terrestrial ecosystem, we can have a forest ecosystem, we can have a pond ecosystem, we can have wetland ecosystem. So there are different kinds of ecosystem. Then we can have the ocean ecosystem and a number of different types of. Okay. So there is always a probability, say for example, when we talk about the Amazon rainforest. Okay, now Amazon rainforest is basically a group of ecosystem coming together. So we have got the riverine ecosystem in the tropical rainforest, we have got terrestrial ecosystem in the Amazon rainforest, then we have got the pond ecosystem, okay, and then we have the, you know, ecosystem that is related to microbials. Okay, so there are different ecosystem that is present, and this combination of the ecosystem which has a natural boundary, that is not a man-made boundary, or that boundary has not been laid out by the human beings. Okay, now this this particular group of the ecosystem basically what we is comprises of the natural boundary, and then it is known as the biome. Now, if you say that we have got Amazon rainforest as one of the biomes, okay. Now, we can have different biomes. Say, for example, Himalayan system can have a biome. Silent Valley can have a biome. Okay, that can be called as a biome because it comprises of different system of ecosystems. Now, all these biomes then becomes the part of the biosphere, or what we can as the call as the ecosphere, or sometimes it is also called as the global ecosystem. So this, say for example, when we started with the organism, we came up to the ecosystem, then we formed the biome. Okay, now we have got Amazon rainforest as one of the biome, then we have got, say, Silent Valley as one of the biome, then we have got the say different areas, say for example Australian rainforest, that is Australian you know, area in the Australia that forms the biomes. Okay, now all these biomes actually becomes the part of the global ecosystem, that is what we call as the biosphere, and in case as we are living on the earth, that is we can call as the biosphere or the earth. So when we start with the organism, that is the lowest category, raising to the highest category as earth. Let's take an example to understand the entire concept of this basics or the fundamentals of ecology. So let's start with the human beings. Okay, so we have got a human being. Okay, so we have got H here. That is a human being. Now there can be different H. Okay, so we can have H here. Now we can have H here. Okay, so we can have different H. Okay, now this, all this are forming the basically the group of humans. Now this group of humans, which are related to each other structurally, functionally, and somewhat behaviorally. Okay, so these are basically called as the species. Okay, now this groups of humans, okay, in say for example in certain areas, say for example Delhi, okay, this forms the part of the population. Okay, so when we have got, say for example, we have got humans in the Delhi, okay, then we have got humans in Kolkata, then we have got humans in Chennai, then we have got humans in, say, Mumbai. Okay, so we have got on 4 metropolitan cities, we have got humans. Okay. Now as this humans, which are the group of humans, so we can say this is, we are taking as this as group of humans. So this is the group of humans. This particular is the group of humans. Okay, now these are functionally, structurally, and behaviorally somewhat similar to each other. Okay, so when they are functionally similar to each other, then they are the group of humans. But as such, they are, so when we say the population of humans in Delhi, the population of humans in Chennai, the population of humans in Kolkata, the population of humans in case of your Chennai or Mumbai. Okay, so all these are population, but when we put them in a group, okay, so we increase the different populations, so we can say the population of humans in the metropolitan, four metropolitan cities. Okay, now here what is happening is that when we move from the population ecology to the ecology of the community level, we have got humans here. Okay, so then we have got dogs, we have got cows, and when we have got, say, plants. Okay, now this pop, so there may, in case of Delhi, if we say, if we are taking this particular example, okay, so what is happening here is that we have got the population of humans here. Okay, so humans coming here. Now similarly, in case of Delhi, there will be a population of dogs, there will be a population of cows, and there will be a population of plants in case of Delhi itself. Okay, so the concept of certain areas remains there. Okay, but with the different kinds of population coming together of the different species, this particular forms the community. Okay, and again, as we have discussed earlier, that in case of ecosystem, okay, this basically the community as include plus, then we have got, say, the abiotic components. Okay, so we have got abiotic components. Okay, so when we have got the abiotic components, it forms the ecosystem. Okay, now what is happening here is that most of the organism that is present here are terrestrial in the nature. Okay, and so this basically forms the terrestrial ecosystem. Now this terrestrial ecosystem, then we can say that when we are talking about Delhi, then we can move to the ecosystem. So Delhi is ecosystem, and on the basis of further, we can say that the India's biome. Okay, and then we can go for the global biome. Now this is overall the concept of basic ecology. So we always remember that we have got organisms as the lowest category and highest category as the earth. And then we will be talking about different concepts related to your species, related to population ecology, different kinds of, you know, R selection, K selections, how the dynamics of the population. And then we will talk about the community ecology, finally leading us to the ecosystem ecology. And then we'll talking about the other aspects of the ecology related to how the dynamics of the entire ecology works. So till then, wait for the next session.